Hi, my name is Kieran Robertson, and it's official, just signed the contracts. I am now a Framus artist, so thank you so much to everyone at Framus and Warwick here in beautiful Markneukirchen. That's right, Markneukirchen. That's it, German, you just got to sound angry.
Yeah.
Markneukirchen! That's it. Angry German. Markneukirchen. Nailed it. I play in the bands Operation Mindcrime and Till Death Do Us Part. I'm here to talk to you a bit about Framus. This is not my custom model. This is a custom model, but not my custom model. Beautiful guitar. It's the Panthera II, which is what I'm going to be getting done in my own custom model. I've played millions of guitars, but I fell in love with this one. My good friend Paul Logue in a band called Eden's Curse is a Warwick artist. And when I was looking for a guitar company to partner with, he told me about Framus and showed me especially this Panthera II, and I just instantly fell in love with it. It's really heavy body, which I like. I like to feel a bit of weight in the guitars. My favorite thing about this guitar is sort of the little details, they walk me through the workshop and it's just, they really care about everything, you know? So the back, the electronic compartments are wood. It's not just plastic. Most companies just go for plastic, it's wood. So makes it look really nice and special and, you know, just shows they really care. The other sort of green flag for me in joining with Framus was they sent me over the Diablo X guitar just to try out and get familiar with the brand. And I'd yet to find a guitar that stayed in tune. I'm quite a heavy player, so especially on stage, you know, really go for it and strum pretty hard. But I played the Diablo a couple of hours, stuck it back in the case, picked up the next day, and it was perfectly in tune. I don't really like Floyd Roses, so it's great to have a guitar that stays in tune like a Floyd Rose, but without a Floyd Rose. And it's due to these locking tuners, which are awesome. So my custom model is gonna be in total white with the gold hardware. It's gonna have the ebony neck, ebony fretboard, not ebony neck, and locking strap locks, everything. So it's pretty standard. The only thing I'm changing on it is I'm going to stick a Diablo neck, which is slightly thinner due to the band Operation Mindcrime does some quite fast sort of shreddy stuff. So just this is quite a thick neck, which is a bit difficult to solo on. We're going out on the road with these guitars starting in January, playing the Operation Mindcrime album in full. I think it's its 30th anniversary. So doing all around Europe, including 11 dates in the UK, and then all the way around Europe. We're doing a run supporting a band called Angra as well, which I'm really excited about to, you know, show my custom Framus guitar on there. Building a custom guitar has been a dream of mine for a while, so, you know, partnering up with Framus for this is just incredible. And there's two cameras, camera one, camera two. So, is this Wayne's World that's out of, yeah, I'm pretty sure. Awesome, cool. Well, just thank you to Framus, and hope you can understand my accent. From Glasgow, Scotland, so it might be a bit tough, but that's going to be pretty much my signature Kieran Robertson guitar, which has been a dream of mine for ages. So thank you very much to Framus for making that possible.